So, what's up, Papa Whoppin' boys, men, gents, girls, ladies, gentwomen, and of course, aviators. We out here gonna talk about the aircraft flight instruments, but more on specifically about the Altimeter. But another butt, let's check out this cool hip intro. Cue it first.
But wait, we already did a cool hip intro.
What the
Jesus!
Well, anyways, check out this cool hip transition.
Hello, once again, good people of planet Earth. My name is Angelo, sometimes Quartero. We are here to talk about the Altimeter. But before that, let us talk about some of the avionics basics, just to familiarize ourselves why aircrafts have and use flight instruments. Now, as a steed, or in this case, a pilot of an aircraft that holds to about hundreds of passengers day in and day out, pilots should have all the guidance that they can get with the help of these aircraft flight instruments, so the good people will have a safe takeoff, flight, and landing. But you might ask,
well, back in the day when Wilbur and Orville Wright took their first flight, well, let's just say that they didn't have any flight instruments in hand.
Well, in most cases, that is true. But those were the early days of flight, where it was still in much development. And it is not ill-advisable now to fly a modern or any type of aircraft without any flight instruments. Fortunately though, the first flight instruments were developed in the late 1920s and made its first appearance in an aircraft in 1929. And Jimmy Doolittle was the first one to test the waters with the first flight instruments. And let's just say, Mr. Jimmy Doolittle actually did something pretty big, so that's a big deal. The altimeter, or altitudo metre in Latin, is a flight instrument that tells the pilot how high the aircraft is above a fixed level. Now, before the altimeter was invented, man was using really long rulers to tell how high the aircraft was from the ground. No, but for real, aircrafts today need the altimeter because there is not much window visibility where they can't really see what is surrounding the aircraft. That is why they heavily rely on the altimeter and other instruments to navigate themselves through mountains, buildings, and the ground basically. Now let's have an in-depth explanation with the altimeter.
Hello, my name is Jared Joaquim Arroyo. I will be explaining the part 2 of the presentation, the definition, aim, and significance. First of all, it is an instrument mainly used for aircraft or any vehicle that requires precise navigation, used to determine the altitude attained. Unlike any old aircraft, modern ones use a new type of altimeter, a sensitive type which is precise and accurate in determining altitude. It can be set using a knob and is much more reliable in terms of adjusting or calibrating the altimeter. Using the sea level, pressure, and differential properties of the atmosphere, the altimeter's determining altitude can be set and therefore inform the operator. The aim of this study is to show and inform the audience, mainly students and future researchers, about the definition, application, and significance of the altimeter. It also encourages students to delve deeper into the altimeter, for in the future, they will be applied to and be of use in their field of expertise. This study also aims to be a general go-to study for platform for students and researchers to look back on as a means of crediting in research, or as a means of relearning what is said in the presentation. In terms of significance, this study will contribute greatly to the research of students and inform future researchers about their subject of study. It may also serve as a guide for students who like to refresh their knowledge of altimeters. It contributes to society as a form of study and research to those who are interested in learning more about the altimeter. Full details about the background and how it functions, its applications, and such.
So, you might be thinking, how does an altimeter work? Or how does it operate? So, let me explain it to you briefly. A standard altimeter contains a stack of sealed aneroid wafers with an internal pressure of 29.92 inches of mercury. These wafers expand and contract based on the static pressure inside the casing of the altimeter. The altimeter senses the height of the aircraft by taking the ambient pressure, which is also known as the static pressure, from the static port, which is usually located at the fuselage of the aircraft. The ambient air is plumbed through the back of the panel and into the back case of the altimeter. Inside the altimeter is a sealed disc called an aneroid or bellows. As the aircraft goes up, the pressure inside the case decreases and the bellows expands. The opposite happens as the aircraft descends. The bellows are mechanically connected to the face of the instrument through gears. By the way, the chamber inside the altimeter is sealed, so only the static air that directly comes from the outside of the aircraft can enter the chamber. So now as the static air comes through the static port to the bellows, the pointer deflects according to the pressure received by the bellows.
I am Aldwin Miguel A. Alianza, and I will be discussing the part 4 of the presentation, which is the function of altimeter. Altimeter is used to measure the distance of the aircraft above sea level or the altitude. This flight instrument uses a static port, which supplies air pressure to the aneroid wafers to display an altitude indication to the pilot. This altimeter also has a device called crosshatch flag, which is used to warn the pilot if the altitude of the aircraft exceeds 10,000 feet. There are two types of altimeter used in aircrafts. It is the barometric altimeter and radio altimeter. The barometric altimeter is the most common type of altimeter used. This is the altimeter with pointers and uses a mechanical system. This calculates the local air pressure in order for it to have an altitude indication. The radio altimeter, on the other hand, is an electronic device used to measure the separation of the aircraft and the ground underneath. It is usually used when the gap is 2,500 feet. That's all for the function of altimeter. I am Aldrin Miguel A. Alianza, and I will be discussing the disadvantages or problems encountered in using analog altimeter. The first disadvantage is the indication is less accurate, which is usually caused by sudden fluctuations or false calibration by the pilot. The next problem will be when the pilot is reading the altitude indication of the analog altimeter, it takes more time before the pilot is informed regarding the altitude. The next disadvantage, regular maintenance is required in using analog altimeters. And the last problem will be the manual calibration needed depending on the temperature and air pressure of the area. So that's all for the disadvantages in using analog altimeter.
The altimeter is one of the many important instruments inside the aircraft. It serves a great purpose for the pilots inside the aircraft. This instrument measures the altitude of the aircraft above a fixed level. Knowing how high or how low you are from the sea level is very important while flying. The altimeter can help the pilot avoid terrains while flying and land smoothly and safely. As aspiring pilots and technicians, we must understand how the instrument works in order to use the instrument safely and effectively. An aircraft cannot fly without this instrument because it gives so much information to the pilot, as mentioned earlier in the video. So that's it for our presentation. We went over some of the basic stuff about the altimeter, like how it works, functions, problems regarding the instrument, and its significance and use inside the aircraft. I hope you learned something from this video. Thank you so much for listening.
Who are the aviators?